What if I told you a $15,000 problem on new gen Mercedes motors could be fixed with just this for pennies on the dollar? My name is Danny Kruger here at FCP Euro, and today we're going to be talking about using a fix from last generation from the M272 and M273 engine to protect the entire wiring harness of several different modern generation Mercedes engines. Let's talk about that. This is going to be pretty much anything from around 2010 to 2012 onwards, particularly with direct injected cars. It's a pretty expensive problem when you do have it, and it's kind of popping up in a lot of cars. So if you want to come in tight over here, I'm going to show you guys what our issue is and what the remedy is that we have for it that's going to save you a lot of money down the line. Honestly, the list of models from Mercedes-Benz that are going to require this fix is just too long for me to even get into right now without wasting your time. Just head down to the description below and we'll have the year and the model laid out right in front of you so you can see if your car is in the window for this fix. Up in front of the motor here, we have some cam adjuster magnets, they're called. These two black units right here, what these are responsible for is relaying the variable valve timing information to the ECU and compensating for the timing on the camshafts. Additionally, what it's going to do is actually fire and control the oil flow, which if I flip over this new one right here, you can see the pin that's going to control that flow. That goes into the VVT solenoid inside of the cover here. So the issue that we have at hand that's popping up on all these engines, it's kind of more common in the M278s, probably because of the increased power that the turbochargers are delivering. But what ends up happening is you have oil that flows up as this seal in here fails, flows up and into the wiring harness. Originally, it's not typically spotted. There's not really any clear signs. But what will eventually happen is you'll get a check engine light for something like a coil pack or an ignition coil rather, or an oxygen sensor. People bring the car to the dealer. Dealer goes to inspect the wiring harness and finds a massive amount of oil accumulation in the harness that can sometimes even reach the engine control unit. Ultimately, what the outcome is going to be for that is a replacement of not only the full wiring harness itself, but also all of the sensors and solenoids that have been reached by this oil and potentially fouled. The bill for Mercedes is generally gonna be somewhere between $10,000 and $15,000. We have a fix right here that is pennies in comparison. So I'll show you right here. There's not a whole lot to it. Literally all you're going to be doing is gonna pull up on this pin and lift off. You can then, for the sake, I'll just use this connector right here. You then check for oil accumulation on the harness side of the plug. So if you do see oil accumulation, that means you probably have a seal that's starting to fail right inside this camshaft adjuster magnet. In that instance, what we're going to do is we're going to unplug this. You're going to undo these E10 bolts right here and replace with a brand new camshaft adjuster magnet. We actually have a kit put together with all of the things you're going to need for this service online. So you're going to replace the adjuster magnet. We also have these bolts listed online. These are one-time use, so you're going to want to grab a set of those as well. It literally just bolts right back in, and then this is going to be kind of the star of the show here. So after you take your liquid moly electronic spray, you're gonna hose out the end of the harness, let things run out, kind of get a little bit of that residual oil out of the car. You are going to take this factory Mercedes part, and you're going to put it between the plug on the camshaft adjuster magnet right here and your standard harness plug. So this is effectively almost like a jumper harness. It's actually called by Mercedes a sacrificial pigtail. And what this does is while it continues to transmit all the information you need, it captures all of the oil that may be getting wicked up the harness and preserves all of your massively expensive components further up the line and your wiring harness specifically. This was actually originally designed by Mercedes for the M271 engine as well as the M272 and 273 engines. Back on last gen when we were still port injected for the most part, M271 changed a little bit further down the line. But this part was made to resolve exactly this issue in the older gen motors. And while it isn't really being kind of shouted from the rooftops like Mercedes did with the earlier gen motors, this does pop right in and it kind of remedies this issue as well. There's a second layer to this. The camshaft adjusters aren't always the only leak point that can foul out your harness. So what we recommend is while you're in here, you've come over to your M276, 278, whatever your engine may be. You've popped this off. You maybe did find oil and you want to replace these guys, or maybe you didn't find oil, but just to prevent the possibility of oil going into your harness, you want to add one of these and not replace this guy just yet. You should also check, right up top over here, your camshaft position sensors. Those are another leak point for this issue of oil in the harness. What's fortunate for us is the connector itself is actually the exact same design as the magnets. So if you are worried about it or you are starting to see residual oil, you can also add one of these harnesses, and it's going to prevent, again, massive problems down the line of oil in the harness. So we also, of course, have the camshaft position sensor on site if you choose to replace that as well. Or if you're looking around, you disconnect all of these connectors, there's no residual oil, and you just want to make sure that you never have an issue of oil in the wiring harness. In the case of the four-cylinder cars, just get four of these guys, one on each cam magnet, and then one on each camshaft position sensor. Obviously, the bigger engines like the V6, the V8s, you're going to double that for each cylinder bank. M256, straight six, same layout as this though. So we'll head over to our C300 just to kind of show you guys what it looks like when it's not in sort of a race car format here, when you're looking at the engine. But it's kind of all copy and paste. It's something, if you have an E10 socket and a ratchet, you can do this in 10, 15 minutes. Anyone can do it, and it's going to save you, again, thousands of dollars down the line if you do end up having oil going up into the harness. So here we have our W205 C300. This is going to be the M274 engine. Basically the same as that M133 over there, but yours is probably gonna look a little something more like this. So if you come on in here, we have the magnets right in front, the adjuster magnets as mentioned, camshaft position sensors are up top, and then the M276, 278, it's going to be basically the same thing, just flipped off to the sides. You did see me holding earlier just one of the sacrificial harnesses and one of these magnets. The kits that you'll find listed online, depending on the engine you're looking at, will actually have the quantity appropriate for your engine, whether that's just the pigtail or whether that's actually including the magnet itself. So that's it for this tech tip. If you have any of these current gen engines, we really recommend you hop inside of the wiring harness, just kind of take a peek at those connectors, look for any oil accumulation, or additionally take some preventative measures to stop a really expensive and really big headache from occurring later down the road. So if you enjoyed this video, if you found this tech tip useful, drop us a like. If you have any additional questions or comments, just leave them below and I'll hop in there and answer them for you. And stay tuned and subscribe for more, because we have a lot more Mercedes and additional European-made content just like this coming your way.